This is part three of a three-part series. This video is for anyone interested in the design of experiment aspect of Avoid the Void. Brooke, let's talk a little bit about the effect of design variables on voiding. What about the stencil?
Well, the stencil is pretty complicated, Phil.
Right.
It really depends on your pad design. You know, the component manufacturer usually has a set of guidelines that they give you, either specifying your stencil thickness or the standoff height that you'd like to have under the component after reflow. But they also, in the case of our components that we use, they also recommend putting like 38 to 80% of the area as solder paste.
Yeah, right.
So just logically, if you're trying to fill the volume of an ideal standoff height,
right,
you're not going to have enough solder to do so. So you're inviting in some voiding to begin with. I ran an experiment where I chose different stencil designs with more solder. So in this case, the pad was complete. It didn't have vias. And we tried to target 100% of the ideal volume of solder that you wanted with the standoff height, and tried to leave different pathways to let the volatiles escape, right? So increasing the amount of solder didn't always decrease the average voiding, but it did decrease the variation and sometimes got rid of those outliers, the high voided components.
Right. So how would you summarize your general philosophy towards stencil design with regard to solder paste volume on ground planes?
I think that we need to balance the amount of solder that we're putting into the solder joint on the thermal pad with the amount of solder that we have on the single pad so that we're not bridging or getting excessive or insufficient solder on those joints. And then depending on whether there are vias, there might be a complicating factor as to what stencil design you might choose.
And there are a lot of variables with the vias themselves.
Right. There are different designs, whether they're tented or plugged, or whether the solder can escape down them. These would all influence the amount of solder that you want to put down and the design so that you're not maybe putting solder paste directly over an open via.
You've done a lot of exhaustive work. It's a fascinating topic. Where can we find more information, Brooke?
For more information, you can find more videos and blogs at indium.com.
Excellent. Brooke, thank you so much.